Hello everybody, welcome to episode 4 of the Old Stream Farm Let's Play for Farming Simulator 2017.
This is grass field at 11. Yeah, grass field 11. So we're gonna reconvene here on grass field 11. But I'm almost out of fuel and fertilizer, so I'm gonna run. Walk over to the farmyard and pick up the truck and the fuel tanker and the seed and fertilizer wagon. So bear with me. I'll head that way and I'll catch up with you guys at the farmyard. Whew, that was a little longer of a walk than I thought it was. What we're gonna try to get done today is fertilizing the rest of these fields and maybe try to start cutting some hay, cutting some grass. You know, I don't even know how many grass fields we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, so we actually have 11 grass fields. Well, I think what we'll do is this first cutting will get our silage ready. And then our next cutting, this next cutting will get our hay ready, because by that time we'll have our straw hay. So, let's see, the truck should be back here, the fuel tanker's right there. Oh, you know what? I left it up at the shop. That's right. I was supposed to bring it. Supposed to have it brought down here. It never was. We'll open up the gate of death. Maybe. That's the first time I made it out of that gate without thing that we're going to get done today, hopefully, is, we got our hay yard, upgraded a little bit. You might be able to see. Anyway, we had a hay barn installed last week. Wilbur Dairies had a contracting crew come out and they fixed it up. We'll be going by there here in a second and I'll show you the yard. Our hay equipment also came in. So we got our baler and our stacker, our silage wrapper, rakes, tedders, and bale forks. So we'll have to get all that hauled in and it'll go over there after we get done spraying the grass fields. I think that's what we'll do. Alright, well, we'll get in the truck and I will meet you guys back at the farm. Okay, we're back at the farmyard. I remembered I haven't given the story about why this toolbox is sitting underneath this tree. I had a story for it last episode, but, you know, editing happened again. The episode of disasters was in fact a disaster. If you guys will remember, our Fendt tractor, which I'll show you here, that we bought was mistaken for somebody else's and given to that person and taken away. So the dealership luckily had another one in stock, and that's it right there. The only difference was the tractor we had was a 720 and this one is a 724, so it has 40 more horsepower than the tractor that we originally purchased. But it only had single rear wheels. So, there's a local man who lives around here. His name's Tony. And he does mechanic, you know, on the side. Well, not really on the side. He doesn't work. He works for himself. He does work. He's self-employed. He's a mechanic. Well, he used to be self-employed, I should say. I asked him if he would like to come work here at the Old Stream Farm. Because we need a mechanic. We're not going to be able to put a lot of our equipment here pretty soon inside of that garage. So he agreed on the condition that he puts this toolbox under the shade tree, because he is a shade tree. So that's what we did. We ready to set his toolbox out in the front yard. When we brought that tractor, he was the one who put the wheels on it.
Oh no, what happened?
Sorry about that cut, everybody. I got a little too eager to back up to the fuel tank, and we ended up glitching out. So I'm going to try a little more subtly. That worked out great. Now up there. That seed and fertilizer wagon I really want to put on the back of a truck at some point. Maybe once we get some real money coming in. Realize I don't think we have a tipper trailer. I'll have to get a container for that truck. Oh, well, I guess that's our tipper trailer, huh? I think it has straw in it. It does. I don't think it's going to amount to anything, but it has some straw in it. Okay, we'll come up here and get the grain trailer. So I've had a little walk around the shop, and I changed my mind. I'm going to put a worker on fertilizing, so we'll see how that goes. I'm going to start hauling equipment. I was going to time-lapse fertilizing the rest of the grass fields because the ones that we have left to do were pretty cool looking. But with this fog, the lighting's not very good. Oh, that's not where that trailer was at all. The lighting's not very good, and too dark for me to see the way the lights on, so I just decided to try put a worker on it. So I'll probably be jumping back and forth between doing what I'm doing, and I need a tractor. Check it up on the work. I think we'll go ahead and take the shield. I was gonna take the fin. I don't think I can. Okay, after a tedious process, we finally got the tractor here. Excuse me. It has made me realize that even that pickup, yes, that pickup, the biggest pickup you can buy to pull this trailer, it's just not going to cut it either. So what I'm going to do is see if I can get my good friend in here at International Agri Center. See if he can give me... Well, I'm going to go talk to the sales representative here and see what kind of deal we can make. And I've got to call our sprayer hand or our spreader hand and see what he's got going on. So please, thank you for your patience. I will be right back. What a great guy. So he is going to call. Those are some slow doors. He's going to call my old, the town I'm from back in the States. He's going to call the dealership from there. See if they can't work out a deal to get a surprise shipped over for me. It's going to cost me a pretty penny, but it'll be worth it. Just don't tell my bosses. No, we're going to work out a deal where hopefully we can trade this pickup for a little bit of cost. It doesn't have that many miles on it, so we can check everything. I couldn't remember if we ordered this with the trailer hitch or not. And I know these two don't match, but this is going to match the tractor. We'll see how that looks. If we don't like it, we can always have our shade tree mechanic take a look at it. So, we're going to go ahead and put this in tandem. Hay barn. Nice. We're gonna stack our silage bales along this fence line and our straw and hay bales. Future silage bales are gonna go in here. Thank you. Yes. Okay, well, I will probably timeline the rest of this following. So I can stop talking. Stop having talking silences. And we'll see you guys when we get back. I guess I need to quit. Alright, well, I will. That was weird. I will see you guys when I come back. I thought I would be a little tricky and switch out my tractors real quick because I needed to get this thing, this front end loader arms. I needed to get them traded out for the bigger ones, but I did some testing. Even though this is a 700 series, I thought it was fit for this one. It's still fit. And I thought the 700 series was in the class where it needed the next one up. So, it's a good thing I didn't buy it yet. But, I need it for, pick those Cortex. What's it called? Cortex? What's it called again? Where's it at? Yeah, the Cortex. Fort Crab. But first, I need to clean these off. I need to paint these arms so they match my tractor. So I'll see you guys back up at the shop. Alright, welcome back. Man, that looks good on this tractor. Look at that. That's what I like about using these on the, I think you can use them on skid steers. I know you can use them on telehandlers and telehandlers and front loaders. Sorry. But I can't remember which other loading equipment you can use it on. So, I'm going to take this and we're just going to drop this in the arm. So, that paint came out kind of nice. I had to try a couple different coats. That quadruple step matched this tractor. I think it'd look better if it matched the baler. It's a big deal right now. I might take these rear wheels off because it's hard to get around this one. It looks so cool. It looks badass. There's a lot of chance of modernization. Monetization is all good. But it does. It looks sick. So, I think we'll leave this tractor down here for now. Just park it. back to the shop, get the pickup. We're going to be coming back in there, so we don't need to shut the gate right now. Get the pickup. Go back down there to the farmyard. And I'm going to switch the case out with the shelter on fertilizing, because I want to cut hay with the case. So I will meet you guys. I'll meet you guys on the way to get the case. Alright, we're back. And I don't know if you guys noticed that whenever I get done using something and I bring it to the farmyard, that I just kind of park it somewhere. But I assure you it gets picked up. At the end of every episode, everything gets picked up and everything gets placed. Not even close. Not even close to being there. So we'll finish it up for him. Needs spraying, spreading. I'm not actually gonna worry about 4, 10, 1, and 15 right now, just because it'll give me something to do later. That's really the only thing that's keeping me from doing that. So, grass field number 1 and 2, I don't think can be sprayed yet. I can't remember if we hit them on the first growth cycle or not. The only fields that are completely done are 17 and everything except for the turn rows that got planted late on 16. I'd like to wait and get these fields fairly full, fertilized and grown up before we cut them, but I don't think it's going to make that big of a difference. Tell you what, I know what we're gonna do. and it's going to be a surprise. So I'm going to get this stuff set up, and I'll see you guys here in a little bit. Okay, well, these are the only two pieces of equipment that we need to move. The only thing I actually bought was this Xylor, because I wasn't thinking. And I rented this JCB log fork attachment for the skid steer, both of them. And also bought a steel chainsaw. Sorry, I'm a little kid. And I also bought the Jens HE700 STA wood chipper, the stationary wood chipper. Maintenance is $140 a day. Oops, wrong button. It only costs $72,000 to place. So as long as I make that money back, I'll be good. This, the log forks. Wrong button again. The log forks cost $105 to loan, $48 an hour to run, and $9 a day, I guess. So hopefully by the end of the day we make $72,105 at least. Hopefully we make more. But, and then this thing, forgot to even look at it. Is it in here? It'll be in forestry equipment. It's 38,000 grand. And it's okay that I bought that, because I'll probably do trees again anyway. And if not, I want to see if this thing will... If I want to get rid of trees that I don't necessarily want to cut up and go sell, I can use this to mulch them down. So I'll just keep it. It's no big deal. But I'll go get the hook lift truck and the flatbed and load the skid steer up. Load that stuff on there, and we'll head to the forest and start cutting. That's a good thing to know. So, I'm going to go ahead and get some of these trees cleaned up. And then we will reconvene here a little bit. Actually, I decided I'll probably stick around for the first couple of trees. Now, Mr. CDP, he always makes the Scorpion King for this, and he cuts his into 1 meter length. Which you can do, but I find a cheaper way to go about it is the one thing I hate about this. Gotta be so precise. But doing it by hand is it's cheaper and it's just as effective. But what I'll do is I'll just cut this tree into little segments and one by one carry it over here and throw it in. Only thing that, let's see if this gives me a price for wood chips here. Ah, get in there. Get in there, log. Huh, that's too heavy to throw. Ah. That's not going to go in. Go in. The price should pop up. 580, so it does give me a little bit of a... So yeah, that's my routine. I'll go through here. I'll probably cut down this whole corner up to there. So the next time you see me, this whole corner here will be gone. And that's why I brought the log torch. The ones that are way over there, I can hopefully pick the tree up. I can cut it a little bit longer. Segments picked each deal up if I have to, but I will see you guys here in a little bit.
All right, we're back. As you can see, I got this whole corner cut down. The only thing I have left to do is I'm going to cut these line of trees out, and then later this autumn out of after harvest, I'm gonna come in here and plow probably I might try to keep this hump in there just for a little extra fun. So I'll probably cut down these three trees also. Excuse me. I'll move that wood chipper back there somewhere, and I should have this little corner ready to go by winter. My original plan for this was gonna be just taking it from about right in here somewhere and cutting all the trees down to square this field up, but up in here it's real bumpy and I don't know if it'll work. I'm going to end up cutting this whole forest down anyway. So if it does look like it'll work, I can always add on sections by sections. As you can see, our money's gone up here in the last few hours. Not all that's from logging. I think we started out with $66,000. And after I finished logging, we were up to 110,000. And then we got a great demand for canola, so I went and sold our canola stock, so we're out of canola now. But one thing I decided to change, I'm gonna take that hook lift truck and take it to the shop, because there's one thing I wanna purchase before the end of this episode, so I will see you guys up at the shop. All right, we're here at the shop. So I decided that I want to get rid of this trailer. Just because I think it'll be easier to just put a hook lift container on that truck, and then I wouldn't need four or five different pieces of equipment at once. So we'll go in. We'll go in here and we will sell our trailer. Sell. Tippers. Okay. Well, I went ahead and went with the, what's it called? I already forgot. The skip. I mean, I don't really have that big of a demand right now. I mean, I don't have a lot of crops. I mean, my biggest field is 17, but I think I'll be able to fill that whole thing up and be able to make it back to the farmyard and back to the field without really running into too many problems. So, it's a basic container, you know. That's all I need. So I'll hook this up and take it to the farmyard and that completes this episode. So, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. Leave a like. Give us a like. Leave a comment. Let me know you're here. Let me know you were here. Say hi. I'll say hi back. I'll try to comment to as many of them as I can. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on down the road.